So you have a blank model or a model that contains data that you want to update or replace. Wondering what to do next? In either situation, you can get data into your model using the Data Management Workspace. First, you can import the data as a draft source, with the option to choose from a range of data sources or import the data from a file. When the processing is complete, you have up to 7 days to complete the data preparation steps to integrate the data with the model before the imported data expires. When the file contains a lot of data, you perform data preparation based on a sample, with any adjustments applied to the full dataset when you're done. Here, ensure that all columns from the data source on the left are mapped to the appropriate dimensions, attributes, and measures defined in the model. Indicators show how much of the mapping has been done automatically. For dimensions that aren't automatically defined, just drag and drop the columns to map them. Dimensions with attributes appear stacked and can be expanded. Keep in mind that mapping attributes is usually optional. In the Details panel, you can see more details for the model, including additional mapping options. By default, dimensions are updated with new values. This is relevant when you're importing to a model that already contains data, and means that if there are new dimension members in the data, changes to the attributes or values of existing dimension members, or changes to hierarchies, these changes will be applied to the model, except for public dimensions. You can choose to convert the value symbol by account type, which matches the value symbol, positive or negative, to each account type identified in the model, for when values are stored as positive, regardless of whether they reflect income or expense accounts. You can also choose to fill applicable empty ID cells with the hash value to preserve rows without a value in the dimension ID column. These rows would otherwise be deleted. You can choose to update, append, clean and replace a selected version of data, or clean and replace a subset of data. With the update method, any values that aren't already in the model will be imported, and any existing records for which the data has changed will be updated. Existing records that are unchanged are ignored, so duplicates won't be created. In most cases, update is the appropriate option. With the append option, all existing data in the model is preserved, and all data from the data source is imported. Any records that are present both in the model and the data source are duplicated, which may result in inaccurate values. With the clean and replace version method, the records for a specific version are deleted from the model and replaced by those from the data source, while preserving master data such as dimension members. The clean and replace subset of data option is similar, but lets you replace the data just for specific dimensions. Next, specify the version for which you're importing data. You can import it to an existing version, like actuals, or create a new version, like budget. Keep in mind that it's also possible to import data to more than one version from a single file or data source. When data from more than one version is available, you need to select the version dimension and map each version from the data to the desired category and version. Before you finish mapping and validate the data, you can choose to omit validation for specific hierarchies to allow non-leaf members to contain data. Once all options are defined, finish your mapping. Success! To import data to another version, such as budget, you can repeat the import process and choose the appropriate version. For more details, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.